Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmanov and today I'm making a baked chocolate cheesecake tart. You're going to love this recipe. I'm making three tarts, so the recipe ingredients you see are more than what you need for one tart. But don't worry, I have the link in the description below for you. Now I've got some cookie crumbs here, which you can use graham crackers or your favorite cookies. And I've got some melted butter. I'm going to add the melted butter to the cookie crumbs and give it a good mix so that all the cookie crumbs are moist with the butter. I'm going to pour this into my tart pan. I've got a 9-inch tart pan. I'm going to spread this evenly towards, especially towards the corner, so that I can bring it up to the sides of the tart pan. And then I'm going to use a measuring cup like I have, or something, a glass, something like that, and press it firmly. Now this is very important that you press it nice and firm so that when you cut the tart later you have a nice slices, otherwise the crumbs fall apart. And chill this in the fridge while you prepare the filling. Next I'm going to melt the chocolate in a microwave at 50% power and put it aside so it cools while I make the rest of my ingredients. For the filling, I have some cream cheese and some sour cream, which I'm going to mix together. Now, very important is never over mix a cheesecake batter, and this is like no other cheesecake. So you got to make sure that you just mix enough to combine the ingredients together. I've got some sugar. I'm going to get that in as well. And then I've got some vanilla. As you see, I'm not overdoing with the mixing. You don't want to add too much of air in your batter. And I've got some cocoa powder and some cornstarch. You can use flour as well, but cornstarch keeps it nice and smooth. Now I've got all my ingredients in. I'm going to scrape the sides of the bowl and get all the powders that are stuck to the bowl inside. And I'm going to give it one last mix. The next ingredient is eggs. Now I'm making three tarts, so I've got three eggs, but you're going to need only one egg for one tart. Now the list of ingredients is on the blog and the link for it is below this post or in the iCard above. So I will give you the whole details below. Notice that I stopped mixing because I do not want to over mix my batter. So the chocolate is cooled and I'm going to add the melted chocolate to the batter and I'm going to fold it with my spatula. I've also got my oven heating at 150 degrees Celsius and I've also got the water boiler on so I can put some water in the pan when I am baking the tart. Now I'm going to bake this in a water bath and I'll show you exactly what that means. Now you can see that my chocolate has all been well incorporated into the cheese batter and I'm going to pour this into my tart. Now I've already poured it into the two tarts before, so I'm going to pour this in this one. And you notice that you don't really need much of batter. This is a nice light dessert when you want to keep something small. So this is a 9-inch cart. I'm going to shake it and put it in the oven. Now notice I've got two baking trays. One is a large one and one is a small one. The tart is on the small baking tray, but I put the water on the outside in the large baking tray. I'm going to bake this until it's nice and set. And you notice I put my finger by mistake inside there while I was trying to test it. But don't do that like me. So I kind of went to see if it's done and by mistake I punctured it. Okay, so I'm going to let this cool for a while, at least an hour or two. Next, I'm going to make the chocolate glaze for the top. Now I've got some chocolate, some butter, some whipping cream and light corn syrup. I'm going to heat this in the microwave and melt it completely until it's nice and smooth. Then I'm going to pour it over the tart. And you see that one? You don't need much because you don't want the chocolate to overpower the tart. So I've got a nice thin layer going there. But when you see when I cut the tart, you will see it's not really very thin. It's kind of just enough to give it that chocolate. I'm going to spread it by just shaking the tart because I do not want to create any spatula marks on top. And I'm going to let this tart cool in the fridge for at least 4 hours or overnight. And then the next day you will notice that the tart is nicely set. Okay, I'm going to remove the tart shell, put it on a platter, and I'm only going to dust some powdered sugar for this one, but you can do many other things to decorate the tart. You can use fresh cream, which is at the moment not an option for me because of the weather. The weather is really hot and humid in where I am, so I'm not going to use any fresh cream for this one, but you can use fresh cream. And this is just powdered sugar. And that's all for this tart. This is a beautiful chocolate cheesecake tart baked to perfection. And it's a very simple and easy dessert, so make sure you get the recipe from the link below. As always, my blog is detailed, and you will find all the instructions, including frequently asked questions. Don't forget to subscribe to my video and hopefully like this video. I'd love to hear your comments if you have any in the comments below. Bye bye for now. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a lovely day.